to you. I hope you can hear me this time. Tell me about the efforts being done by UNICEF in KZN.
Thank you so much, Gareth. Thank you to your listeners as well. We have just spent the last 2 days under the leadership of the UN Resident Coordinator, Ms. Nadia Sbekele-Thomas. We have met a number of provincial leaders, starting with the Premier and his entire team, also the Speaker of the Provincial Legislature and the entire Etekwini Municipality. We've also met business leaders. We have met civil society organizations, as well as young people who have enterprises that were affected in the last 2 weeks. We visited yesterday a number of locations that were impacted. These include areas in the Katomena, where one of the partners had an innovation lab that was destroyed. Everything was stolen, everything was lost. We also visited Isipingo Town, which is a hub, a central business district here in Durban. And we talked with the business community to get a sense of the loss. And it was intriguing to hear that some of the businesses that were burned and looted are as old as 8 years and 100, which means they've been providing vital services to the community for the past 80 to 100 years. So the impact has been huge. We witnessed it. We talked to people who confirmed this. The tragic loss of life, the damaged property, but also the psychological impact of what happened. It is really damage and impact beyond the physical infrastructure. And of course, the disruption of the basic services. So this is what we had. This is what we saw in the last 2 days.
So what are you going to be doing about this? Because it looks like you've spoken to some people on the ground, the stakeholders. You've got a real sense, Muriel, haven't you, of what is needed? I've got about a minute, maybe 2 minutes left with you as well. What are you going to do to now assist those people? And what do you need from people watching at home? How can they help you in any way?
Yes, so the UN family in South Africa has about 17 agencies that are actually working here. What we will be doing, and this is really building on our previous cooperation, the UN is not new to KwaZulu-Natal. We've had previous collaboration, previous work that we're doing in the area of health, education, livelihood support, economic development. So building on that past relationship, and building on the plans that we were actually working on prior to the recent unrest, we will be working with the provincial leadership and all the partners to immediately respond to the impact of the recent unrest. It's important to restore livelihoods. It's important to have social cohesion. It's so, so critical at this time. It's also important to address some of the psychological impacts of what has just happened. So there's the rebuilding in a physical sense, but also rebuilding in the social sense of rebuilding trust, rebuilding social cohesion, and engaging the entire community. I think what is also important, and this is the role that the UN can play, is facilitating and helping to bring together different partners to make sure that the recovery, the rebuilding, happens in KwaZulu-Natal.
I appreciate your time. It looks like a lot of good work being done by you and your organization down in KZN, certainly